Bismillahirrahmanirrahim and assalamu alaikum. My name is Rabia Abid and my roll number is EP170121 and my topic is hypoglycemic effect. First of all, I will talk about the laboratory findings for the hypoglycemic effect of the drug. So how we will prepare the hypoglycemic effect and how we will discuss the hypoglycemic effect of the drug. So for that, we need to induce hyperglycemia in a rat or a mice. For that, we will administer streptozotocin intraperitoneally. We can administer the glucose water. We can administer the alloxygen monohydrate. So there are several other techniques by which we can induce hyperglycemia in a rat or a mice. So what is streptozotocin? Streptozotocin is a naturally occurring chemical derived from the streptomyces acromegens, and that is particularly toxic to the insulin-producing beta cells of the pancreas in the mammals, and it is widely used in medical research for treating certain cancers of islets of Langerhans and to produce an animal model for the type 1 diabetes. And basically, we are comparing here two results between the control group, and we have injected streptozotocin, which is exhibiting the results that reduce plasma insulin level and elevated blood glucose level. So I'm here giving a reference of the article with respect to the streptozotocin. So we have compared two models we have compared here, that is streptozotocin induced severely diabetic rats and streptozotocin nicotinamide induced diabetic rats. So there are two models which are being compared. So why we are comparing them? We're comparing them to compare their characteristics and to investigate the hypoglycemic effect of the anti-diabetic drugs. So results show that in the streptozotocin induced severe diabetic rats and the pancreatic insulin content decreased to approximately 10% of that in the normal rat. But recently studies have shown that mostly people use the streptozotocin nicotinamide induced diabetic rats in mouse models. Now we'll talk about the material and methods. The materials used here are streptozotocin, metformin, glavenclamide. So these two are anti-diabetic drugs, and it is a hyperglycemic drug or chemical which is used to produce hyperglycemia in a rat or a mice. Here animal models are being used, like male Sprague Dawley rats, and whose are only seven weeks old, and after 8 weeks we are starting their studies. So here we have taken the two groups and we are comparing the results after overnight fasting. So we can say that how we will evaluate the characteristics of the mildly and severely diabetic rats. So we can compare their results by measuring their body weight. We can measure their blood plasma glucose level, insulin, glucagon-like peptide. And how we will compare them and how we will measure them? We will measure them by taking the blood samples from the tail veins of the rats, and we can take the portion of the pancreas to measure the insulin content. So here I'm discussing the two groups, like normal rats we have taken in which only vehicle is administered, and other diabetic rats in which vehicle, voglibose, metformin, glavenclamide, insulin, sitagliptin, and these all are administered in these amounts. So after 30 minutes, a liquid meal was orally administered and blood samples were also collected after 15 minutes. And statistical analysis results are expressed as the mean, SEM, the significance of the differences between the normal and diabetic groups was assessed using the student's T-test. So here we are comparing some results when we are giving the streptozotocin alone and streptozotocin along with the nicotinamide with the variation in the doses. So we can observe here graphically that the glucose level is at normal condition, it is normal between 200 to 400 range. But when we are administering the streptozotocin, the level has been increased to 800. And when we are giving them with the variation in the doses and the doses are increasing, so we are observing that the glucose level is decreasing. Although we are administering nicotinamide along with the streptozotocin, which is hyperglycemic agent, but the level of the glucose is decreasing. And we are seeing that insulin, when we are introducing the normal, normally we are not administering any kind of a drug. So the level is normal between 150 to 200. But when we are introducing the streptozotocin, the level of the insulin is very much decreased, below 50 occurs. And when we are seeing that when we are giving the streptozotocin along with the nicotinamide, as the doses are increased, the insulin level in the body is also increasing. Now we will talk about that in the basal level, and after 15 minutes we have administration of the food. We are talking about these effects of the drugs and normal. The normal and vehicle are same ranges when we are giving in the basal level, but after 15 minutes of the administration of the oral liquid, we have seen there are variations. Like vehicle, the level is increased, insulin level is increased. When we are administering the voglibose, the level is voglibose and metformin, the level is not much increased. It is not giving much good effect after 15 minutes, but we have seen very drastic changes in the insulin level when we are giving the glavenclamide 10 मिलीग्राम पर केजी, सिटाग्लिप्टिन 3 मिलीग्राम पर केजी एंड इंसुलिन 0.5 इंटरनेशनल यूनिट पर केजी. सो वी हैव सीन दैट द इंसुलिन लेवल इज इंक्रीज्ड. हाईएस्ट लेवल ऑफ इंसुलिन वी हैव ऑब्जर्व एंड वी आर गिवन द इंसुलिन लेवल आफ्टर 15 मिनट्स ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द फूड. सो वी कैन डिस्कस द रिजल्ट दैट इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द स्ट्रेप्टोजेपिसिन इंड्यूस एंड स्ट्रेप्टोजेपिसिन निकोटिनामाइड इंड्यूस डायबिटिक रेट. So results are being shown that streptozotocin alone when we are giving, so it is only preparing the severely diabetic diet. But when we are giving it along with the nicotinamide, it is preparing a mildly diabetic diet. So however, the streptozotocin induce hyperglycemia, body weight loss, and decrease in the pancreatic insulin content. So here we are seeing that in streptozotocin and nicotinamide, 100 mg per kg induced diabetic rat, glucose tolerance was mildly impaired due to the loss of the early phase insulin secretion. So discussion is all about that when we are introducing the streptozotocin alone, it is severely diabetic rat, and when we are giving it along with the nicotinamide, mildly diabetic rats are being produced, we can say. And we can say here that we have already observed the results are varying, that when we are giving it along with it, the results are varying and the ranges are increased. So the result is quite increasing in the insulin level and decreasing in the glucose level. And when we talk about the drugs which we have been administered, so best results are being observed by glibenclamide and sitagliptin and insulin. They are giving the best results of the 15 minutes insulin level is increasing, but not by them we are not seeing good results. So this is all about the discussion of the two models, and we can say that on the basis of the insulin responsiveness to the glucose and insulin secretagogue, we had demonstrated that this experimental Rett syndrome resembles type 2 diabetes, and it may prove useful in the evaluation of numerous antidiabetic agents that possess potential insulinotropic action. This is all about this topic. Thank you.